Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, my name is Desiree, and today is part 4 of how to buy a house in LA in 2019. We're covering the escrow process. Now, a lot of you have heard this word escrow before because it's so popular, but don't have a clue what it means or what the heck happens. But basically, escrow is a third party that's gonna make sure that everything that you signed in those contracts is actually happening. Usually the escrow process is 30 to 45 days. It takes 30 days for the buyer to get a loan approved and funded. Now there are different steps that happen throughout the escrow process. Your offer has been accepted, you're ecstatic, and you're ready to open escrow, which means start the purchasing process. Just because you wrote an offer and it got accepted does not mean you are obligated to actually close. You have what's called 3 contingencies. You have a home inspection contingency, you have an appraisal contingency, and you have a loan contingency. In short, once you're okay with the home inspection, once the appraisal is okay, and once your loan approves, then I'll buy the house. If all 3 of those things don't happen, you as a buyer have every right to cancel escrow, get your money back, and head for the door. Now your offer has been accepted. You initially have about 24 to 48 hours to wire your initial good faith deposit to escrow. This initial deposit is part of your down payment, so it's not any additional money. It's just part of it to say, hey, I'm serious, I want to buy this house. It's in escrow for them to hold until I finish getting my loan approved in the next 30 days. Once that happens, you have, per standard contract, 17 days to get a home inspection. Now, we do like to condense the time period down just so you find out right away whether the condition is safe enough for you and meets your standards. Again, there's no perfect home, but there are certain things that you want to look out for, like the electrical, the plumbing, and foundation. Now, if you know the plumbing is original, that doesn't mean that it's not worth it. It just means that, hey, I know that eventually I'm gonna have to fix all of this plumbing. Now, the inspection is about $300 to $500, depending on the bells and whistles that you ordered with the home inspector. And they're actually gonna give you a 50-page full report explaining every single detail that they found with the home, from cracks on the driveway to the doorbells not ringing to there's a leak. Every little nook and cranny, a licensed inspector is going to find it and send us both a report so we can negotiate, if need be, repairs or credit or a lower sales price. A licensed realtor can give you their recommendation, but ultimately you as a buyer have full control over what you want to do. Now, the appraisal is also about $500, and it is part of your closing costs. The bank that you're getting your loan from hires an independent appraiser to go ahead and inspect the home and make sure that the home is worth what you're offering. So even if you offer a home that's worth $500,000, you offer $800,000, if an appraiser comes back with a report and says, hey, this house is worth $500,000, You can't buy the house at $800,000 unless you pay the difference in cash. The appraiser is a safety net, in my opinion, because the bank is gonna have to make sure that just because you're offering something crazy doesn't mean it's worth it, and they have to protect themselves as someone who's letting you borrow the money. Because if you can't make the payments, they get their money back by taking the house back, and if it's not worth it, they're losing money. So just a refresher, you sent your initial deposit, you've done your inspection, you did an appraisal on the home. Now you're completing the loan itself. And once you meet all of their guidelines in order to be approved, you get what's called loan docs. The loan docs is the written contract of how the term of the loan is going to play out. 30 years, FHA, conventional, and if you've seen part 2, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And if you haven't, shame on you for skipping. But it has the term of the loan, it has specifics of the loan in the loan docs, and it's pretty much set in stone, and you're signing your life away for 30-year mortgage. Just kidding. Once you've signed those loan docs, we wait for what's called funding. Now, funding happens when you're sending your last of your down payment and your closing cost fees, and the loan is funding and sending its money into escrow. The last of the money, because remember, you only had the initial deposit. All the rest of it is going into escrow. Usually in the LA County, we wait another 24 hours, which completes a 30-day escrow period for the grant deed to switch over to the new name. So it was on the seller's name on title. We'll have to change over through the county records into the new homeowner's name. Now that you're legally a homeowner on title, that's when me as your real estate agent goes to pick up your keys and meet you at your new home to deliver your keys. Now I know I did summarize that. Please give this video a thumbs up so I know that you liked it. Comment all of your questions, subscribe so you don't miss any additional information, and a huge thank you to everyone who watched part 1, 2, 3, and 4 of How to Buy a House in LA in 2019. Make sure you go to my website, estradadesiree.com, if you want me to represent you in the purchase of your home. And until next time, thank you everyone. Bye-bye.